Welcome back, superstars, to UC Star Astralis. I'm your astrologer, Cyndi. This is going to be the general horoscope reading for you Libra people out there. So, happy Easter to all of you. Check out my Easter-looking glittery t-shirt. So, dear Libra folk, let's get it on. This is the general horoscope reading for Libra, April 2018. Now, we have this Mercury going retrograde in your seventh house of business, contracts, relationships, diplomacy, open enemies, best friends. Yeah, you got it all here. Of miscommunications with Mercury going retro, miscommunications, contracts not really working out, maybe you didn't read the fine print, and so you may have had miscommunications with people who were one-to-one friends, with your marital partner, business partner, okay, anyone that you're in a contract with, things probably weren't, the communication between you and them probably was not very good, okay? Now, then on the 15th of April, Mercury goes direct. That's the kaboom day of everything to go, like, to hell with miscommunications and everything. That's like the worst day is the day it goes retro and the day that it goes forward, and give and take a few days before and after. And that I have definitely seen, and have definitely over and over have seen with Mercury going retro. So this is going to be even worse. I'm sorry that I have to tell you this, because Mercury going forward on the 15th of April is conjuncted with the new moon in Aries on the 15th of April. New moon usually means new beginnings, but those new beginnings always need to, something always has to come to an end, and that's what I definitely noticed. Those new moons, the astrologers like to make it all like peachy and cream, but I definitely noticed new moons, there is no emotion. The moon is gone. You don't see the moon. And when the moon is full, you feel your emotions are very strong, but it's not emotions being very strong. Nevertheless, all I have to say is that if you were single and you met someone and got sexually involved with them or romantically involved with them while during March when Mercury was in shadow and then in retrograde, I'm sorry to have to tell you, but if the foundation wasn't strong enough and you met them during, then the foundation isn't going to be strong enough, because when it goes forward, you're going to end up finding out they weren't who you thought they were. Maybe they were married. Maybe they were, you know, maybe you were talking to them online and then you find out that they're 25 years older and they were showing you a fake picture all that time. Who knows? But if you were involved with anyone romantically, especially through the internet, you're going to get like the scare of your life to find out that they weren't who they said they were. Okay, so any kind of a contract, any kind of a love bond contract or a business contract can come to an end. Hopefully you didn't get married during this time, because that's definitely not good. It's going to be wishing you could just like tear the contract into pieces, finding out this person is crazy. Okay, now the new moon, usually something comes to an end so something can begin. Okay, so the new moon is afflicted here with this Mercury going direct. Nevertheless, you will feel the new beginnings happening a little bit later in the month. Okay, so So on the 17th of April, 2 days after this, you also get Chiron, this very slow pacing asteroid entering Aries, your seventh house. And I really feel for you, but on another level, you Libra folk, this seventh house has all to do about Libra, because the seventh house belongs to Libra. It is your destiny in life to accomplish this constellation. It is your destiny in life, in this lifetime, to graduate. And Chiron, okay, is not going to be easy with Chiron. But Chiron will bring some people into your life who are going to get into your face like this and tell you what you're doing wrong with relationships, what you're doing wrong with your friendships, okay? It's very likely that you're going to want to defend yourself and make excuses for yourself, but don't fight Chiron. Chiron will bring people into your life to give you the message. Don't fight the messenger. Don't hit the messenger. I learned a little bit of Thai boxing last Friday in Kung Fu, so. Okay, so anyway, you don't want to hit that messenger, even though you're going to really wish you can bop their lights out. Chiron, if you fight against him, it'll only get worse. If you're not getting the lessons will be knocking on your door louder and louder and louder. So, take it cool. Take the chill pill. Accept the message, flow with it, okay? Accept the message and flow with it. It's not going to be easy for someone to get in your face and tell you that you're not doing relationships right, that you're not doing business contracts right, that you're not doing the friendship right. People are going to be telling you things that you don't want to hear. But once you start to flow with it, what's going to happen with Chiron here is you're going to try to prove them wrong. No, I can do relationship. I can. And maybe that's what you need, is to try to prove yourself and learn. So if in doubt, if people are telling you that you're not doing this or that right in regards to all the things that have to do with the seventh house, that you're not being very diplomatic, then the best thing is to hear what they have to say and to fix it. Go get those books that tell you how to be the best that there is, because what happens is once you start to self-help yourself in regards to these issues of the seventh house, and you, Chiron has all to do with trying to help other people out. You learn it for yourself so that you can help other people who are in the same darn position that you can say in a year or two from now that you were in, okay? And that's Chiron, the wounded healer, where he's always trying to heal everyone else, but he can't heal himself. And you're going to feel this way in the beginning. You're going to feel like, I can help everyone else out with their problems and with their, and tell them that they're not being diplomatic. But it's like needing to take the log out of your own eye and first deal with you before trying to help other people. Go read those books and apply it. So I'm very direct. But that's life. Get over it. Anyway, so Saturn going retrograde on the 17th of April. On top of that, on the same day, is this happening in your fourth house? It has to do with love, with your emotions, with your family, with your home, with your mother, with your car. This is not going to be easy. You're going to be challenged. And then on the 22nd, Pluto goes retrograde again in the same house, the same constellation with the same issues, family, home, car, mother, your emotions. Saturn here is trying, is like this guru, a man with a long white beard, trying to teach you about these things. You may be feeling reprimanded by your family members. Maybe you're trying to renovate your home and things are not going the way you wish they are going. But do your Saturn mantras and your Pluto mantras, and as soon as they go forward sometime in the fall, you're going to be so blessed, because when you do their mantras, these mantras through YouTube for free, just go Pluto mantra, Saturn mantra, whatever, and do them twice a day. They tell you on the video how to do them, and they're in Sanskrit, Indian language. And when you do them, you start to get dreams what your blockages are. And once you get these dreams and you realize what your blockages are, it's just like a deeper aha, because you're getting them. And it's just so different than when someone's in your face telling you what your blockages are. It's more of an aha, okay, I got it, I understand it. And then it helps you, okay? Because it really hits home when you do these mantras, and you'll feel it. I would say, because they say to do it 41 days or 40 days or something like that, and when you're halfway through it, that's when you already are starting to get the dreams, when you're halfway through it. In the beginning, you won't feel anything, but in halfway through, so 20 days about, you'll start to see the difference, okay? 24th of April, Venus is blessing your ninth house of luck, of being able to go on excursions and to travel, or for educational, or learning about other cultures, harmony at places that have to do with courses and meditation and churches, prayer groups, harmony, talking wonderfully with your professors and people, students that you go to university with. This is really, really good for test taking, for writing, for being creative. On the 29th of April, it's a full moon blessing your house of money. So that was the general horoscope reading for Libra. Hugs and kisses. Happy Easter. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. I know where you live. No, I'm just kidding. Okay, don't freak out. Bye.